And when I ask y'all how you know, do you know what I'm talking about? Since knowledge comes from experience, homeboy, words ain't nothing but fucking information. All right. Now, what I get y'all in the habit of is when I ask you some shit like that, go there and tell me about it. You understand what I'm saying? That way I know you know what I'm talking about. Because, you're down with it. All the way down with it, not just intellectually. You get my drift? So if I say, do you know what I'm talking about, that's a difference than me saying, do you understand? Understanding is a motherfucking mental process. You know, you got to live in this motherfucking world, not in your head. So when I ask what you're talking about, I'm talking about some real shit, not that. You know, low self-esteem kept me fucked up. Because I was so busy doing something to make my motherfucking self feel halfway decent that I ain't had time to do nothing else. You see how it fucks with you? You understand what I'm saying? You're trying to get to that place where you ain't feeling none of that motherfucking shame and shit. Because you very much aware of it. If you're an addict, goddammit, and you've been out there in them motherfucking streets, you know, y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about. You may not show it or act like it, but you know exactly where I'm coming from. You in that space. You understand what I'm saying there? That ain't no description. It's a description, but it's some real ass shit. You in that motherfucking space, and you pissed off because you in it. And you ain't trying to hear no whole lot of shit about it. Just give me some motherfucking money or some dope and get the fuck out my face. I ain't trying to talk about another goddamn thing. I'm feeling shitty. Any goddamn way. Every fucking day. Right or wrong. Do you understand where I'm coming from now? Now, that's some real ass shit. That's how it plays out. Now, we call it low self-esteem. So, you see the difference between low self-esteem and that other shit I was just talking about? I was talking about that shit, but I was living that shit. See, that's real. That's what the shit is about, living the goddamn shit, not running around lecturing people about the shit. When you lecture and shit, you avoiding the goddamn shit. And you don't learn how to avoid pain by talking a whole lot of psychobabble and shit. And you fucked up beyond all recognition inside and talking some profound shit. you see what I'm saying? To cover all that garbage and shit that's going on in you. You talk all that good ass shit, and then as soon as you get up out that room, you go get yourself some jank. you see what I'm saying? Because you've been standing up and lying your motherfucking ass off. You ain't feeling or doing none of that shit you talk about. You fucked up and you just trying to get through this shit so you can get at what you really want to do. Now you understand what I'm saying? Yeah, paying his motherfucking dues. You know, I'm going on and break them off a little something, something. Then I'm going and break me off something for my goddamn self. See, my needs is pretty goddamn simple. You know, I don't need a whole lot of shit. I need a couple, you know, give me some cash so I give me some chain. I'm good. You know, I ain't got all these other needs because I done run that shit away from me anyway. The little bitches fuck with me. My people don't fuck with me. My friends fuck with me. The only thing I can do is put some of that shit in me. To get all right with me. So, see, when a son bitch in that kind of shape, he ain't a real friendly type person. See, and I got my mug broke down, not because I'm trying to threaten a motherfucker. That's just how the fuck I feel. you know what I'm saying? So I got to get all right with me. And the way I do that is, you know, I do what I do. I use something. Whatever. You see, abroad, if I need some emotional validation, that's what that clinicians say. You know, I need somebody to dump my motherfucking feelings on and for them to take them and stroke me a little bit and chill my ass out. You know what I'm saying? That might show up. Or that other thing, that always makes me feel good. My self-esteem goes up 100% if I get me a good lick. Yeah, that's better than a bra. See, I, you know, that That smooths out everything. See, I go fuck with Frank. You know Franklin, big face motherfucking Ben. Yeah. See, I fucks with Frank. The bitches come second. You know, I'd rather hang out with that motherfucker all day, every damn day. I can always get me that shit. Get me some money. I'm all right. But to do that, I got to be straight, man. And I don't just mean drug-free. I got to have my head right. And I need some healthy, what I call boundaries, man. What I got to learn how to do really in recovery is practice saying no to my goddamn self. Y'all get what I'm saying? I got to learn how to say no to me. I've been saying yes to my feelings all my goddamn life, and look what the fuck it got me. I got to learn how to say no to all them damn feelings that come up to tell me go cop something. I ain't talking about no dope. You know, I ain't even thinking about that shit. I didn't use so much dope and shit that I don't even fuck with that no more. It wasn't. This shit, getting high wasn't even working. You know, because when I was high, I knew I was fucked up. Do you understand what I'm saying? That's when getting high stopped working, right? Even when you're high, you know you're fucked up. So it ain't no use spending no more money on that shit, right? Because it ain't taking away the knowledge and the fact of me being fucked up. See, most people think it's when you run out of money or you're sick. Nah, I was clear as a song. That's the clarity that come. You know, even when I was using, I got that place where even getting high didn't take away the reality of the fact that I was one fucked up individual. So that's what it used to do. See, when the drugs was working. You know what I mean? When the drugs was working, I could put some good shit in me and go sit down and I give a fuck about nothing no goddamn more for a few hours anyway, if the shit like that. You know what I'm saying? But then it gets to that place where even when you're high, you still know you're fucked up. So ain't no sense in spending no more money on dope. I mean, for real. This shit ain't working no more. That's what I mean when I say it ain't working. Anybody know what the fuck I'm talking about? See, you know, so you don't really quit the shit. You outlive the motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Life is a process of experiences. That's what life consists of, experience, right? See, that's what I meant when I said tell me about shit. I mean experience itself, not the textbook shit. It might be some textbook G shit, but that ain't what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? And you got these experiences, one right behind the other one. So you gotta have that experience in order to find out what the fuck you need to know. That's how you learn what you need to know. Through the experience that you have, right? So this joint really is like surviving the experience. You outlive this shit. You live through it and get to that place where, hey man, this shit ain't working. You know, I'm spending all my money and I ain't getting shit. I ain't even getting fucking high like I wanna. I wanna get high when I ain't feeling none of this no self-esteem and shame and guilt and all that shit. And this motherfucker ain't taking that shit away no more. Even when I'm high, I'm feeling the fuck like that. So it's time to stop spending money on that shit. Right or wrong? I spend some money on some shit that's working, but the dope and all that other shit stop working. Because every time I wind up doing this shit, I wind up in a motherfucking rehab somewhere. So, I mean, what the fuck? I'm spending a whole lot of money to go into treatment. That's the dumbest motherfucking thing in the world. Think about it. I done spent a whole lot of goddamn money to go to jail. Now you tell me what kind of shit that. See, I don't think you see this shit. I done spent all this motherfucking money to go in a rehab. See, when you get to that place and you see some shit like that, that's when you say, God damn. Boy, I'm about one dumb ass. I ain't lying. You just have to go ahead and accept that. Because that's a motherfucking fact. I'm serious. That's some painful shit. Now, you can dress it up with all this drama and who she and he and who struck John and who fucked who and why and all that drama. The bottom line is that I done spent all this money to get in a fucking rehab. I could have went around the world and enjoyed my goddamn self. But what I do, I took every goddamn cent I had and bought me a seat in a rehab. And I want to share something. Shit. Is that real, ain't it? See, one thing like that when you're running out there having fun putting that shit in, you ain't see what you had bought yourself a ticket on. You know, you I don't know what the fuck you had in mind, but that ain't, see, that's where that thinking shit comes in. And see, if you had been looking instead of thinking, you'd have seen the shit. Now you understand what I mean when I say y'all was like a blind man wearing sunglasses looking for a black cat in a dark room at midnight. You ain't seen shit. Dig it? If you had been looking instead of thinking, you wouldn't be sitting in the son of a bitch. Check it out. That's what we mean by stinking thinking. That's what got you the fuck in you. Not the way you think, but thinking, period. Because, like I told you last week, thinking is an indication that you don't fucking know. Because if you know, ain't shit to think about. What y'all use thinking for is to escape, intellectualize, taking what is and turn it into some other kind of shit. Taking what the fuck it is and calling it some other kind of bullshit. Taking that goddamn codependency shit and calling it love. You ain't seeing what's happening. You being emotionally abused, you controlling, you jealous, you manipulative, and all that. And you up in your head, well, I love this bitch. Hey, you see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? I don't even want, that's why I tell people when they come in there fucking with me, hey, look, Jack, I don't want to hear a goddamn thing about nothing. Well, they say, well, how you going to know? I say, by looking at your ass. That ain't going to lie. Now, that shit coming out your mouth, that's some shit you put together. Tell me how the fuck you got in you. Do that. I don't want to hear about nobody else. No people, places, and things. I want to know how you got in you. You see? And you going to come in and tell me about the world, people, places, things, and I'm like, hey, Jack. So what? That's how shit is. How you get in here? See, you were too busy thinking. You wasn't seeing what was going on. You saw what you thought was going on. You saw what you thought you could get to go on. So you running off of your guy, you living out of your head, and the real world tearing your ass up. You getting your ass whipped, and you go up in your head and try to figure out why, instead of getting off money for that son of a bitch. See, you ain't even howling the shit right. What difference do it make why you getting an ass whooped? See, in the real world, when an ass whooping come up, I got two choices. I either run or fight back. I ain't going to sit down there while somebody whooping my ass. Man, will you please explain to me why I am getting this ass whooped? That's the dumbest guy. You see them? Fuck why I'm getting it. That ain't the question. The question is, I get this thing up off of me. Yeah. That's what the real shit is. You see, you ain't even asking the right questions. You coming at this thing wrong. It ain't about how you got it. That's history. Fuck how you got it. You got it. Right? The question is, how you gonna carry it? You better learn how to carry it, because the motherfucker ain't going nowhere. I ain't lying. This, you can bet on that. See, they don't have motherfucking brain transplants. They ain't got to that shit yet. They probably never get that. See, the brain runs the whole show, right? So you can go somewhere and get you a new brain. But the brain has the ability to reconfigure itself. For real. It can do that. It can do that. And you get a different brain format by learning and practicing a different way of doing shit. You see? It's just that simple. Because if you don't get a different brain format, you ain't got no choice but to run off of what you've been running off. And if you run off what you've been running off, you're going to run right back into the same shit. You see what I'm saying? So you just need to practice doing things differently. And that puts you in charge of your life right now. You see, you're coming to a meeting and sitting in there is you putting a program in your brain that's going to be useful to you down the road. And the more you do it, the deeper that becomes. So the habit of staying clean and looking out for yourself develops the same way the habit of fucking yourself up did. You see what I'm saying? You put a lot of work to get into practice of doing all this dumb shit, so you need to put in a lot of work of doing some correct shit. And it ain't gonna feel good because it goes against how you've been doing shit. But you can get used to it over a period of time. You see what I'm saying? And that's the recovery process. You totally in charge of that shit. How you in charge? Whether you choose to do it or you don't choose to do it. It's entirely up to you. I mean, it ain't up to me. Whether you get straight or not, it's up to you. I mean, I give you information, you know, like that. You know, I'm an addict just like you. So, you know, we the same motherfucking people. For real. Ain't no damn difference between me and you. Except I've been clean longer than most of y'all. Got more experience in this field because this is what I do. You know, but you don't need to know all the shit I know. What the fuck good is going to do you unless you're going to do the same shit I do? And I don't think you want to fuck with this shit. I'm serious. I tell people all the time, y'all don't know what you get yourself into. You know, you going to deal with a population. Boy. If you ain't a dope fiend, my advice is don't go fucking with them. I'm serious. If you ain't a drug addict, don't. I mean, you feed a drug. I tell people who ain't addicts, I say you have to feed them with a 10-foot spoon. You know, don't go fucking with no dope fiend like that. Because we ain't right. I'm serious. I got to admit that in order to keep that shit in check. See, I got to get real about that. I ain't 99% of the time I'm going to be aware of what the hell I'm doing. Right? But there's a piece of me, a big ass piece of me, I mean a big, a damn near all of me, that ain't about shit. 99, it's them principles that keeps the dope fiend in check, see, cause I ain't right. I'm serious, I know. I look at shit like you do. That's the honest to God truth. The first impression that anything makes on me is exactly the same impression that it makes on you. Soon as I see something, I'm putting a move together. Yeah. I ain't bullshit. Yeah. Any of y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about?
Yeah. Or as soon as you hear something.
I'm a fucking predator. I ain't bullshitting. I ain't lying. That's why I can deal with a whole bunch of dope fiends and shit when most people... See, because I'm honest about who the fuck, who I am. See, I know me, boy. Shit. No, I've been a dope fiend too long. You know, ain't no damn way you get rid of that shit. But I'm glad that I know it, right? But I'm going to tell you the damn truth. If it wasn't for those 12-step principles that I practice, I don't go to meetings and shit because I don't feel like hearing that shit. But I ain't lying. Because no matter how correct I say some shit, I also know why the fuck I say it, if you understand what I'm talking about. See, I ain't learn all this shit in college and out no goddamn book. You know, I had to survive, you know, Vietnam and the streets and the prisons and the drug dealing and the whole goddamn nine yards. I had to do the same thing that you had to do. Whatever the fuck I gotta do. and not spend a whole lot of goddamn time ruminating over the shit. You see what I mean? And that's how I am. But I done learned from that experience that shit don't feed the bulldog. That shit put me in a rehab and in prison and in ICU and all that kind of shit. See, and I don't feel like fucking with none of that. I done had enough of that shit. You know what I mean? The court and parole. I don't feel like being bothered with none of that kind of shit. Or toxic ass people with a whole lot of drama and shit going on. Take that shit somewhere else. You know what I mean? See, I done been in too much of that shit. The dope and the whole goddamn thing. You know what I mean? I make me some money off of them and get the fuck on out of them. You know what I mean? I can survive in it because I can walk right in it. And don't nobody know goddamn difference because I ain't walking around with no motherfucking sign on saying I'm a therapist, right? I don't even, you know. And I don't know nothing but people that's fucked up. You understand what I'm saying? Because of what I do, damn near everybody I know is fucked up one way or the other. If you know me, you either a relative or you done fucked up something. That, you know, that you can bet on. If a motherfucker know me, you know how he is. You see? I mean, for real. You dig what I'm saying? The only way, if a motherfucker know me, only one way you get to know me is by doing the kind of shit that you've been doing. And that I used to do. See, so... You know, I tend to stay the fuck away from people. I mean, for real. See, because that's all the fuck I know. And I can walk up on some shit, and before you know it, I be the woke up slew foot, and this motherfucking thing that's arrested, this addiction, I walk up in some bullshit, and this son of a bitch get out on his own motherfucking recall, and it's on. You see, he don't need no bail, but he don't need shit. He get out on his own goddamn recall. He sees some shit in his own. And it's normal to him. See, and that's right underneath the surface of what you see standing up here in front of me. That motherfucker is alive and well. I'm telling you, he ain't went no goddamn where. So check it out. When you come meet with some shit, trust me, you ain't got to explain a whole lot of nothing. Because the thing of it is, when you start explaining some shit, that other son of a bitch show up. And when you start explaining, I see an explanation as a motherfucking move. Oh, yeah. You know what I mean? Real shit don't need no explanation. When you gotta tell me a story, that's a motherfucking move. You trying to get my head into whatever however the fuck you laying some shit out. And my question is, what the fuck is you telling me for? Yeah, that's a move. My question is, when you even come up to me, is what the fuck you want? Not good morning, how you doing? Because that opened the door for you to bring me a move. But as soon as I see you, I want to know what the fuck you want. Because that's how it is. But I have to keep that in check. You know what I mean? I got to make a conscious effort to do the right thing. See, because my whole goddamn half of my life, the first half, I probably won't get another half lung. I don't know. I don't give a fuck one way or the other. You know, but I'm going to do what I'm going to do anyhow. How long, I don't know, and I ain't trying to figure that fuck out. All right? But the first half was about fucking up. Everything.
Yeah, man.
I don't mean... You know what I'm saying? I mean, when we fuck something up, is different from when other people fuck something up. See, when we fuck something up, it ain't no fixing that shit. See, we burn the whole goddamn bridge. We use a motherfucker up. We don't have, you know that thing say, half measures avail us nothing? They ain't only talk about the program, they talk about how we get down. See, that's what they said, half of some shit ain't never. No. I want the whole goddamn thing. And then I want one more. Then I want to know where you got it the fuck from. See, so that's how we are. See, so we can't afford to get caught up in that shit, because once you open the door to slew foot, boy, that motherfucker, it's on. So those principles, like, keep that son of a bitch in line, but it shows up every now and then. It shows up even when I'm at work and stuff, you know. I ain't lying. I can go off at work sometime, and I felt bad as shit the other day. My program manager, she's a sweet young lady. She's a nice woman. She's really sweet. I really care about Monica and shit, because she's trying so hard to be helpful. But they laid a whole lot of shit on me and then told me some shit that wasn't correct. And I told her, I said, look, from now on, when shit come in, yeah, you give it to me. Don't read the shit and tell me what the fuck you think. Because you ain't seeing the shit right. You understand that? Well, I'm just trying. I say, yeah, you're trying to be helpful, but I'm telling you the shit is fucking things up. Right. So then I seen the tip. Man, I felt like shit. Yeah. I was fucked up. I ain't lying. That whole motherfucking day. You see, and that shit will come out when I don't want it to. You know what I mean? And I can get like that, especially when we talk about some money. See, I ain't got no whole lot of. Yeah, for real. That shit ain't fucking negotiable. It ain't about how the fuck you feel. I don't give a shit. You know, this is straight up business. You know, and that's how I see shit. A relationship or anything else is business. Because if I treat it as anything other than business, it becomes subjective. And then I start feeling some shit. And I don't need to feel a motherfucking thing. I need to get paid. You see what I'm saying? And I can keep straight like it. I ain't selfish and greedy. It just keeps me on my... See, because money ain't some shit that you can fuck around with. You can if you're drunk and crazy. But if you see shit clear, you know that money, you got to work that shit. And it ain't no second chances. When you spend it, it's gone. When you fuck it up, it's gone. So money keep you on top of your game 100%. I mean, for real. You know, it ain't about getting and spending. That's addiction. It's about keeping you focused on some real ass shit. So you don't fantasize about no money. When you fantasize about money, you go out and take your last motherfucking dollar and try to hit the goddamn multi-million shit. And believe you gonna hit some shit like that. Now that's fantasizing. You just done fucked up some money there. See, I don't fuck with no shit like that. See, I ain't spending no money on nothing that I ain't got control of. That's what I use my money for, to control what I need. You see what I'm saying? So I ain't gonna be spending no goddamn money on some shit that I ain't got no control of. You see what I'm saying? And that keeps me in control of me. Because I know I need to do that and manage that shit in order for me to have the freedom to be able to go home and sit down and close the door and ain't got to fuck with nobody. See, freedom ain't free. It costs money. And to get money, you got to have your head on right. You even get your skill or a motherfucking strap. You see, it ain't a whole lot to that shit. I mean, oh yeah, they'll break you off motherfucking check. Enough to get you some tater chips and shit for the month. Fuck you gonna do with $185 a month? Shit, I used to fuck that much money up while I was taking a shower, putting my clothes on. Ready to go out and get fucked up. I'm laid on $185 worth of bullshit. I'm fucking with that while I'm getting ready to go out and fuck up some more money. And you mean tell me that's got to last me a whole goddamn month? That'll hold your ass down, won't it? Yeah. What time did I start this shit?
We're at 40 minutes. We're good.
We're at 40? Oh, I ain't know where I was at the thing. You can, you know, you gonna edit it, right? Yeah. Yeah, okay, good.
That's that stuff about Monica.
Yeah, yeah, take that out there. Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, man, women and children, I'm all right with them. You know, I'm all right with a bitch. Yeah, I like bitches. I ain't. See, a bitch has got passion. See, a bitch got energy. You know what I mean? A bitch is a challenge. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? One of them little laid-back, meek motherfuckers, they can fuck with you too, see, because you feel guilty when you fuck with them. You know, but a bitch, see, you feel like... See, the dope fiend in me needs some shit like that every now and then. See, every now and then I got to go in the hood. You know what I'm saying? I this ain't sociably acceptable or none of that kind of shit, right? But see, I like the clubs, I like Blues Alley, I like shows, I like all that kind of shit, see? That's all right, too. But every now and goddamn then I get this motherfucking itch. I got to go down there in the hood and get me one of these motherfucking G bitches, you know, one of them ride or die motherfuckers, you know, that I can get my shit off on, you know, with no hard feelings, you know, because that's how she get down too, you know what I mean? So that's cool too. It's all according to how you want to play it, you know what I mean? I mean, according to where you're coming from. You know, it's all kinds of, women got all kinds of personalities, you know, and all of them, you know. So, you know, it's all good. It's all good. I don't take that shit personal, you know. It's like blaming a motherfucking snake if he bite me. That's what the fuck snakes do. The fuck you blaming him for? See, so you get all crazy about these goddamn women. What the fuck has that got to do with you? That's just how they get down. You know, don't take it personal. See, huh? That's all the fuck it is. You tell me what the hell else it is if it ain't about business. It's about business. Anytime any goods or anything is exchanged, right, and bartering and negotiation and buying and selling, I damn sure it is about business. Why? What else is it? That love shit is fantasy. Right, you can indulge in your fantasy, but you got to deal with your reality. Right. See, and the reality of life is you ain't got no money, you ain't got shit coming, love or nothing else. Check it out. Now you can go get in some dumbass shit and call it love, but my thing is, what is the effect of the relationship on you? That's how you can tell whoever's any good or not. What purpose do it serve in your life? And if it's just sex, then that's all the fuck it is. You see? But if you want more than that, you're going to have to kick out more than that. See, and what I was saying about that low self-esteem, you had to get up off of that shit. See, your self-esteem is based on this thing. It's a cultural thing. We live in a country that's a capitalism. That's money. That's the system that we live under, right? And that's what it is. The way they measure people is by what they got. See? And the way this culture is set up is that they got it set up where your self-worth is equal to your net worth. If you understand what I'm saying. In other words, if you ain't got shit, you ain't shit. And you believe it. You know, I know you believe it because you feel like it. See, so that's what I was talking about coming out the gate. Your self-esteem is tied up in your ability to compete in a world where material gain reflects the value of that person. Right? So you caught up in this illusion that without anything, you ain't worth a goddamn. So what you do is try to feel better and feel better about yourself by going out and using a whole lot of different shit to front off. You dig it? If you got the front off something, then you ain't real. You see what I'm saying? If you got the front off some shit, you ain't real. Who are you when you ain't got that front? You see, that's where I'm coming from. Who the fuck are you when you ain't got that front? I mean, that shit always comes up. Motherfuckers front off of recovery. That ain't bullshit. Y'all seen it. This shit used to be real bad, man. You used to go to meetings and the son of a bitch would be parked outside the meetings and the Cadillacs and the Benzes and all that shit and the bling and everything and lay it up out there and everybody looking, oh, that motherfucker doing good. I said, shit, he's doing that when he was slinging. Only thing now, he's slinging 12 steps. See, he's still slinging now, he's slinging some recovery shit and getting paid and, you know, shit don't change. It don't change. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It don't change. The attitude is what changes. You see what I'm saying? The attitude is what changes. I'm still the same son of a bitch I always been, right? I just don't have the same attitude about myself and about a whole lot of other shit. The shit's still there. It's still like it is. It's still what it is. It ain't changed worth a fuck. My attitude about it is that I don't really give a fuck about it. None of it. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
So it can hurt me, but I really don't give a fuck about it no way. You dig it? What I learned in life is the biggest hurt I ever got was from the shit I cared about and the people I cared about. Strangers couldn't hurt me. It's the people close to me that do. And they hurt me because I cared about them more than I cared about me. Y'all hearing where I'm coming from? You hear what I'm saying? Difference is now that I look out for my goddamn self. And I care about them, but not to the point where I'm where what they do gonna fuck with me. You understand what I'm saying? That's my old lady, the girls I see, the family, anybody else. I got some boundaries that say, nah, fuck that. And I don't have no guilt and shame and none of that kind of shit if I tell them don't fuck with me like that. See, so the only thing changed is my damn attitude. Really. Really. Even my behavior is designed to keep me straight. You understand what I'm saying? It ain't whether people approve or disapprove of it. I could give a fuck less. What I do is for the primary purpose of keeping myself straight. You see what I'm saying? Even dealing with y'all, I'm helping my goddamn self. You understand what I'm saying? I done had those experiences. I told y'all about the time when I was working at the Hickey School, right? I had put together this program out at Charles Hickey School back in 1985 mm-hmm. to 1991. I put together a drug treatment program out at the Hickey School. And this was for them goddamn hoppers, you know, that they was going to have, whether decide whether they was going to send them to adult or keep them as juvenile. And they were battling with the people out there all the time. I had these motherfuckers that was behind the barbed wire. See, they had them big motherfuckers that was doing this shit. They was behind the barbed wire. Everybody else was in cottages and shit. So I had them sound bitches. Right. They 17, 16, they's big motherfuckers, you know, at that age. Them motherfuckers feet bigger than Shaq's. And shit. And they healthy and light fighting and thug, you know, they laid back with the Timbs and shit, jailing, bitten. I said, damn, how I get these motherfuckers. Right? But the thing about it, me and them was tight, because, see, I had the ability to keep them out of court, send them to a treatment center, and keep them out of the adult level. So they kind of looked out for me. Me and them was tight, all of them, because they knew. And these little motherfuckers, we used to kick it. The rest of, you know, when they went somewhere, they had to have the police around. But when they were with me, I ain't need no cops. I tell the police, nah, see, when you show up, they get all crazy. So if you stay the fuck away from them, me and them is okay, right? So they got used to it being like that. But every time I be with a crowd of them, them people in the administration building be looking out the window. I went back, they say, you know, you got everybody upset. I say, why? Because you was out there with 10 of them guys and you didn't have no protection. I said, I don't need no motherfucking protection.
Yeah.
Well, we just don't do that. I said, look, me and them cool. They ain't, you know, we all right. Short and them told me, this little motherfucker told me one day, hey, Mr. Kerr, how much money you make? I said, man, ain't none of your goddamn. He said, nah, Mr. Kerr, it ain't like that. Say, what I'm trying to say, look here. He said, you looked out for me and I'm going uptown tomorrow. And what I was going to do, I was going to, you know, give you my address. So, you know, when you get off from work, you come past and holler at me, and I'm going to help you get back on your feet. I look this little motherfucker. I said, ain't this a bitch? He said, no, I'm Miss Carrie, straight up. I said, man, get the fuck on with you. So about 5 years later, I'm up on Park Heights and Northern Parkway. Y'all know where Pimlico is?
Yeah.
And that lady over there that read palms and shit. Yeah. My old lady lived around on Nelson Avenue off of Rogers, right? Yeah. So I'm coming across Northern Parkway and we walking down Park Heights Avenue about 2:30 in the morning. Boy, I hear all this motherfucking noise and shit behind me and shit, and me and her walking. And I look back, boy, it was around about 15 or 20 of them some bitches. And you know, when they out that time of morning, they all hide up and raising hell, and they walk right up behind me and her, and she holler, I ain't there. I said, look, you better shut your goddamn mouth. Don't start no shit, but you just shut up. You know what I mean? So they walk right behind us, and then they split up and walking on each side and in front. And I'm saying, God damn. What kind of shit is this? And then somebody said, hey, Mr. Kerr. I said, hey, sir. Hey, Mr. Kerr, it's me. You remember me? You remember how you helped me out to school when you helped me go uptown and everything? Hey, y'all chill out. That's Mr. Kerr. He cool. I said, phew, God damn. I say, hey, Shawty, you behave yourself. Yeah, Miss Carrie, I'm cool. I appreciate it. Come around and see me. I say, all right, I'm gonna holler at you. They went on that boat. I don't know who that little motherfucker was, but I'm glad the fuck he knew me. You understand what I'm saying? Because I was an ass whipping. I know what was coming. You know what I'm saying? See, so I know from experience, right? You help as many motherfucking people as you fucking can. Because you don't never know how that shit gonna come back at you. You understand? You understand what I'm saying? See, so you know where I got that shit from? Y'all ever seen The Godfather? Marlon Brando? What was he doing? And he would tell them. They would ask him, what can we do for you? He said, nah, nothing right now. But the day gonna come when, you see, and that's how shit works. It's called karma. You see, it might not even be you. Right? But it's gonna be some motherfucker gonna show up when I need some shit. But see, I set that up my goddamn self. You see, that's how that shit works. And I done seen it happen time and damn time again. So it ain't in your real good interest to go around fucking with people. If you can help somebody, go ahead and do it. And judging and all that kind of shit, because trust me, man, this shit can flip in a New York goddamn minute. Well, y'all know what I'm talking about. Shit, you can be doing good, feeling good on top of the world, go out and get yourself some jank, fuck all that money up, wake up in jail, and I'll god damn how the fuck I do that.
Right.
You know, so take your time, start looking instead of thinking. See, you ain't seeing shit. You up in your head trying to figure shit out. Ain't nothing to figure out. You need to do what you need to do to get the fuck up out of here.
That's right, bro.
Okay? That's it, Chris.